Hello and welcome to another coding challenge video. In this coding challenge, I'm going to implement something called a diastic machine. So the diastic machine that I'm going to build here is going to be based entirely on a technique, a diastic technique invented and pioneered by Jackson McLowe, artist, poet, composer, playwright, who pioneered a lot of algorithmic chance operate techniques with around language to generate poetry. Without the use of a computer. So there's a long history of artists and poets working with algorithmic computational methods to generate language, to analyze language, and this is something that is really easy to forget in the world of kind of computers and learning to program, that so much of this kind of stuff can be done manually, and I encourage you to explore ideas similar to this with manual processes before you start to implement them digitally as a way of exploring and playing around. You know, there's another famous example is William Burroughs' cut-up method, which is called the cut-up because it's literally about making new text from folding and cutting pre-existing text and mashing them up together, which of course you could do with a computer, but you could also do with scissors and that sort of thing. But let me get beyond that. A great reference for this, by the way, that I'll also mention is The Virtual Muse, Experiments in Computer Poetry. This is a book that you can I'll link both to Jackson McLowe, pages about Jackson McLowe, as well as The Virtual Muse, a book in this video tutorial. But let me just read to you the description of a diastic machine excerpted from Charles O. Hartman's book. The process began with a striking phrase from Virginia Woolf's The Ways, ridiculous in Piccadilly. This is going to be known as the seed phrase. So in the program that I'm going to write, I need a seed phrase. He reread the novel, this is referring to Jackson McLowe, looking for the first word that, like ridiculous, began with an R. Then read the next word following that had, like ridiculous, I as its second letter. Then the next word whose third letter was D, and so on until he had spelled through the whole phrase. So if that didn't make sense to you, let me come over here and kind of diagram this out for you. So let's say, surprise, surprise, I have the word rainbow, and I have some text like Ralph sat on, oh, that didn't work actually, painful ferns. Okay, I'm designing something to work precisely in a way that I could demonstrate this. So let me look in this text for a word that starts with R. Aha, Ralph. Let me look in this text for a word that has its second letter A. Sat. Let me look for a word that has its third letter I, not on, but painful. Sat, painful. Its fourth letter N, F-E, ferns. So you can see this idea of taking this seed phrase and finding words in an existing body of text with just the single letter in the same spot and creating a new phrase out of that. And this is a way, in a sense, of saying, I want to generate poetry, but I, the writer, don't want to play a sort of human being role in it other than sort of selecting the seed phrase and the source text, let the algorithm kind of do the talking, so to speak. And this is, I think that you, as a viewer of this video, I would encourage you, I'll reference some other examples of this, to generate your own system for doing this and see what types of outcomes you can get. Maybe you'll make a Twitter bot from it, that sort of thing. Okay, so coming back over here, let's go and start with I have an empty sketch here, an entirely empty P5.js sketch, and I'm saying no canvas because I don't want to see a canvas. I'm not drawing anything in this. And I'm going to just find this here, and you can see I put a header in the HTML file, Jackson McLowe diastic, and I don't see anything on the page. So the first thing that I need to do is I want to get a seed phrase. I'm going to let the user type in the seed phrase. So what I'm going to do in the HTML file is I'm going to say, make a paragraph element, and I'm going to say seed colon input ID equals seed slash input, and I'll make sure it starts with rainbow. So now we can see I have on the page seed, and I started that with rainbow. Now I need to, in my program, get access to that. And also, I think it might make sense for me to add a button. ID equals submit, and submit will be the text of the button, so I'm adding that in. So now I have seed rainbow, and I have a submit button, and I want to attach, so now I want to attach an event. So this I have to do in JavaScript, because I'm now, if this is the structure of the page in HTML, and now I'm just going to affect the behavior of the page in my JavaScript code. So I'm going to say var seed equals select seed, var submit equals select submit, and submit dot mouse pressed. Now I'm going to do something I haven't done in a lot of my other videos. I tend to stay away from this. I could just say, like, do the thing and then define that function down here. But I'm going to take this as an opportunity to show you something, which is an anonymous function. I'm just going to put the callback right in here. Oh, that's very awkward looking. But it's actually kind of a nice way of writing condensed code. When you click the mouse on the submit button, the submit button, execute this code that's inside this anonymous function. It's anonymous because it doesn't have a name. So what do I want to do right there? Just to see that it's working, I'm going to say create p seed. Well, obviously you're going to need to do, and not seed, but seed.value, the text of the seed itself. And I'm going to have to do a lot more there, of course, but I'm just going to say that for right now. So now, if I hit submit, we can see this page is doing some basic stuff that is at least getting the seed. So I have the seed. Right? Now I have this seed in my code. I need some sort of source text to use to be the words that I search for. So the way that I'm going to do that is I'm just going to load from a text file. And I happen to have a text file here which just has a lot of text from the Wikipedia page on rainbows. So I'm going to do it the easiest way possible in my code with just preload. So I'm going to write a preload function. And I'm going to have a global variable called source text. I'm going to kind of call it a goofy name. I'm going to say source text equals load strings rainbow.txt. And one thing you might recall if you watch some of my other videos is that the load strings function loads in the text, but loads it as an array. So it gives you each line in that text file as an array. And so what I'm going to do in setup is once that text is loaded, I'm going to say source text equals join source text with a space. So I'm going to get rid of that array and join it so I have one long string. So now I have one long string and I just got to make sure it's there. I'm going to also say create p source text. So now if I hit run, if I reload the page, I have the seed and I have the source text. So now I've set up the page. That's just sort of step one. Now I actually need to implement the diastic algorithm. Okay, so let's go back to our code and do that. This is going to be fun. And actually I just realized here's something that I want to actually do. I want for my diastic algorithm, I want the source text not to be one long string, but I want it to be just an array of words, a list of words. So I'm going to create a global variable called words, and I'm going to say words equals split, and I'm going to use the p5.js function split tokens, and I'm going to say split that source text up by, and split token says whatever, these are the delimiters, the second arguments are the delimiters. I want to split it up by space, comma, exclamation, anything that's basically something that's not a, so you know, I could do this much more effectively, but I'm just going to do that right now. And I'm going to do this, and I'm going to look just in the debugging console, and I can see I have an array of basically many, 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 many words. So I have all the words of an array with every single word as a separate element in that array. And you can see that it's 2,132 words long. So this is what I'm going to be able to use now. I'm going to search through that array to find words that have, and by the way, it's probably going to find rainbow over and over again. But I'll deal with that later because I'll give it a different seed phrase. OK, so here we go. Now what I want to do is instead of creating those paragraphs, I want to say, let me execute a diastic with what? I want to pass in the value of the seed, and I want to all of the words. So I'm going to write I'm going to have that function take a seed and an array, and that function will return a diastic the results of this diastic technique. So I'm just going to go to the top of my code now, because I can kind of worry about this algorithm as its own thing completely. And I need a function called diastic, and it gets a seed and a bunch of words. And I'm using the same variable name. So what's the first thing that I need to do? The first thing that I need to do in the algorithm is look at each character one at a time. Because I need to find a word that starts with R, a word that's second letter is A, a word that's third letter is I, that sort of thing. So I'm going to come back over here, and I'm going to say what? For var I equals 0, I is less than C dot length, I plus plus. And then the character that I'm working with is seed car at. Boy, this is a function that's part of the JavaScript string object that I think I neglected to mention in some of my other videos. If I say car at I want the character at index I, right? And in a string, all characters have an index. Index 0, index 1, index 2. So if a string is 5 characters long, like hello, the indices go between 0 and 4. So once I have that, I want to then have another loop. And what do I want to loop through? I want to loop through every single one of the words. And I want to say, if words index j dot car at I equals C, then I have found a word, right? I found a word that has its own character at the same spot I as the character I'm looking for. And once I do that, I'm just going to say console.log just to see if this kind of idea works and break. So here we go. I'm going to run this program now. I'm pretty sure I'm going to run this. We should see a bunch of things. So look at this. I got rainbow 7 times. So first of all, let's do a different seed phrase. This is, you know, testing 1. Just do testing 1. You can see I got T-E-S-T-I-N-O-E, and that's all. So you can see this worked. Now, I got some of them twice. So here's the thing. One thing I need to build into this is I need to say after, the reason why I got rainbow 7 times is because my loop starts over every single time. So every single time I find a word, I go R matches with R, then I go A matches with A. So one thing that I need to change about this is I need to, while I'm doing this, keep track of some things. So I need, first of all, I need to have a phrase. I want to kind of have a phrase which starts like this. And when I find the word, I want to say phrase plus equal. I want to concatenate. So the plus operator joins two strings together. I'm going to say plus equals words index J. And then I'm going to say return phrase. So one thing that's going to be nice about this, now that I've done this, is I can stop using the console for debugging, and I can say create p phrase. So let me run this again. And you can see I got rainbow, 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 rainbow. And I say test. I got that meteorological dispersion, that. So one thing I want to do, by the way, is I also want to add a space. So I'm going to do this a sort of silly way, but I'm just going to have two lines of code there. And you can see rainbow, 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 rainbow. So now what I want to do is make sure I look for the next instance of a word after the first one I found. So I'm going to keep track of that index, or like current word equals 0. So I want to start my loop when I look through all of the loops from current word. So I want to go from current word to the end of that array. And as soon as I find one, I want to say current word equals j plus 1. I want to go to the next word. So instead of this loop of searching through all the words, always going back to the beginning, I want to save where I last found one and start from the next one. So this should do this. Rainbow caused rainbows, rainbows, rainbow, rainbow, rainbow. So I'm still getting a lot of rainbows, but I can now say things like, do unicorns exist? Question mark. So during good, about, during moonlit, numerically, direction, encounter, dispersion, brightness. Now, amazingly, I'm not getting any errors here. And I probably should do some error checking, like what if I got to the end of the array? and I don't have any more where more to look? What if no word exists with that in there? So I'm going to sort of leave this as that. I'm going to release this code. Another thing that I could do is track all the possible words that have O is the second letter, and I could always pick a random one so that each time I hit submit, I get a different one. That's something that you might add to this. Error checking is something that you might add. I don't know if there's anything weird happening when I have a space, because I'm actually, space is technically a character that I'm checking. So the question mark is in there, but it seems to be working. Let's just D, O, space, U as fourth letter. So you can see, so I got to do some stuff, clean up that sort of way. So I probably missed some things, but I encourage you who are watching this video to play around with this code, make your own Diastic, tweak the algorithm, generate poetry, share it with me, share it with the world, and explore other types of ideas. And if you're in the Programming from A to Z playlist, the next video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about this and a homework assignment for this set of material and some other types of techniques and historical algorithms like the Diastic that you might look at as well. Okay? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video, maybe, perhaps someday.